Hey guys, Brandon with Bearded CB82. Don't mind the air compressor, it just doesn't want to shut off at the moment. But today we're going to go over the Capri 3/4 inch drive impact sockets SAE. So get the camera flipped around and let's take a look. All right, so right here I've got the three pieces out of the kit that I've definitely used that are received from Capri. I've got the inch and 5/16, obviously it'd be the most used in this shop at this current moment in time. Once we get rolling further down the line, when we'll have additional repairs, bigger shocks on the trailers, that sort of thing, where we have to use a 3/4 inch impact because they're seized, I'll be using additional sockets. Real quick, we'll go over the inch and a quarter. As you can see, it hardly looks used. I used this once to pull a yoke. And as you can see, didn't even phase it, didn't even phase the coatings, none of that jazz. The one thing that it did do was, like I said, some of the corners were just a hair sharp coming out of the box and did exactly what I thought it would do. And it just knocked that little bitty edge that was on those clean off. Made them real nice. Squared them up more than anything, but yep, no longer having a relatively sharp edge there. Coating, yeah, like I said, using this to pull a yoke. Didn't even phase it, so they did a good job on their first run of the coating. Now, these two that I've used the most, okay, this one looks rusty, we'll go over that. Used the extension on about 15 tires, so that's 150 lug nuts ish, give or take a tire or two, with this socket. And I never cleaned them off. All I did was just, you know, I left these two pretty much mated together for the first go, you know, 15 or so tires I did. Went ahead, took that off because I had a couple snug spots to get into and needed a little bit more torque. So you, anytime you put an extension on, you do deal with a little bit of torque loss. But overall, finish on that's held up pretty well. And that, and it being winter, you're going to get a little bit of rust because of magnesium chloride. The nuts themselves will sometimes rust, especially on the trailers. Onto the studs, so you're always going to deal with rust coming off or things kind of rusting in that manner. And never having oiled it or anything else since, definitely held up nicely. Ball still works great, didn't seize up, didn't lose the ball, so there's that. You can see just a tidbit of wear on that guy on the inside. So extensions held up really well, I've got no doubt in those. Now this guy, overall use including today, probably around 35 or so tires, so that's 350 lug nuts all together. Most of the rust that's in there is from today. And yeah, like I said, I didn't even oil this guy. I got some grease on there from the gun. Get this thing wiped off finally. Never wiped it off, never bothered to. I just wanted to see how it would hold up in our shop anyways. We've got a wash bay inside the shop, so we do deal with some humidity. So there you go. Oh, focus.
Damn you.
And maybe it'll want to, but there it goes. As you can see, the edges actually held up, you know, a lot nicer than you would think for cost per socket in this particular set. For what they run, was it $89 or $99 for the set, something like that, for the 8-piece set. And most other sets that you might get that are somewhat close to that range, they're gonna usually omit this one because they want you to go and buy their 33 millimeter. So Obviously, use the living hell out of this socket as much as I was able to. Told the other guys, feel free to go ahead and use them. I think they were, you know, a little bit more on, well, might as well use the shop's tools. Yeah, that's just the rust from today. So, or mostly today, there's still more down in there, but oh well. You know, just true test to all of that surface rust coming off the nuts. So, overall, how did she hold up? Actually, she held up really well, especially considering Chrome Molly, a little bit better suited for impact use anyways. So I'm really happy with the way that this has handled itself quite well. And yeah, overall, is the kit worth it? Are the extensions worth it for what they run? I think so. When I start looking at other brands that I know about and or have used in comparison, you know, Sunex, I think, runs pretty close to the same price-wise and probably pretty close, you know, quality-wise, maybe. I haven't personally used too many Sunex, but overall, holding up really well, especially on a 3/4 inch impact on the straight drive, really held up nice. So doing its job quite well. Now the cons, I wish that Capri did offer a set in metric as well. Well, because the way some things run, you know, you never know. Especially when you're trying to do engine work and you do need these. I wish they would also offer them in a shallow set and then also add additional kits where you could, basically a supplemental kit where you could either buy sockets individually or buy a whole kit all the way up to 2 inches. Because yeah, once you, sometimes you need them, especially big shops, you're more likely to need them. Automotive shops, you're usually not using a 3/4 inch impact. You know, half is usually as big as you'll ever need in an automotive shop. But in a tractor shop, workshop, something like that, I think if they offered kits where you were able to go ahead and do that up to, you know, 2 inch on the size would be really good. Shallows, deeps, and also the same in metric. You know, so it's just, you know, a little bit of thing for them. And also being able to purchase individual pieces as well as other companies would, I think would really expand their line quite a bit also. Overall feeling on these, pretty decent. I'm happy with them. You know, especially the extensions. You go and you buy some other little cheaper priced extensions, that little guy's gonna be the first thing to go. And so 150 tractor and trailer lug nuts did good. Damn air compressor. So anyways, would I recommend them? Yeah, I would. I think for the amount of use that if you need it, well, odds are if you're in a shop like mine anyways, you're gonna need this socket more than any of them. And the fact you don't have to go and purchase one additionally, you know, be it 1 5/16 or a 33 millimeter for, I mean, what do those run? Like $50 for a regular tractor 33 millimeter. And, you know, hell, there's half your kit right there just in one socket. So I think as far as a deep well goes, I think they got a really good lineup. Next yoke, I got to go do, you know, the more I use these, the more I'll, you know, if I have any issues or anything else, I'll be sure to let you guys know. But yeah, that thing for pulling a yoke clean off the truck on a yoke puller did awesome. So can hardly even tell it's been used. So their coating is there. Relative rust resistance overall is there. Like I said, I had some really stubborn ones. I had to take the torch to them to heat them off in order to get them off anyways. This morning. So definitely overall, you need some big ones and you've been looking at these, or you've been on the fence about them, you know, I don't think you would be going bad choosing this, especially, you know, either a starter kit, or you really don't want to pay that Snap-on or Matco price. I'm not sure what the kit like that would run from Matco, but from Snap-on, heck, this socket alone, just an inch and 5/16 and a half inch drive, that will run you some money. That's like a $70, $80 socket just in and of itself. So there you have it. You know, you've been looking at these, go for it. If you've been comparing these to some other brands out there, you know, make a good choice. I mean, some other good brands out there too. Definitely won't blame you there. So overall, there you have it. So remember, shop safety is just as important as firearm safety. If you screw something up, somebody could die. Take care.